Hi all, it's Jack from Preact here, and today we'll be taking a look at Dynamics 365 Customer Self-Service Portals. A self-service portal can help a customer get the information that they need quickly and easily, helping to create an amazing customer experience. There are a few main ways that the portal can do this. Firstly, the portal allows customers to see our knowledge base articles. Portals also include forums where customers can speak to each other and ourselves to discuss any issues and share information. Finally, a portal allows a customer to manage their existing cases and create new ones. We're currently on the main landing page, and here we can see a few different things. At the top, we have a search bar that can be used to search all KB articles, forum posts, web pages, and cases that a customer may have open. Below this, we have a great resource that allows customers to see KB articles sorted in a number of ways, such as most popular, most recent, and top rated. If we scroll to the top of the page, we can see that there's also knowledge base articles in the navigation bar. If we click into this, we can see all of our knowledge base articles sorted by category. If I click into 3D printers here, we'll be able to see all of our knowledge base articles that are related to 3D printers. If I click into one of these, we can see that we have a few different options as well as being able to see the contents of the knowledge base article, such as being able to print, rate, and finally comment. Scrolling back up to the top of the page, we can see that the next option on the navigation bar is forums. Within forums, we can have multiple discussions with multiple threads in each. If I click into the general discussion, I can see all of the threads related to these. Within each thread, we can have multiple posts from different people, allowing us to discuss issues or any new ideas that we have. These can all be moderated by staff if needs be. Finally, we have the My Support option. Within here, customers can manage any existing cases that they've already got open or create a new one. There's also a handy search bar at the top should a user want to search for any issues that they've got, such as leveling a 3D printer bed. It's going to automatically bring back any relevant KB articles to deflect a case being created. A customer can also search their cases using views, such as My Open Cases, My Closed Cases, or All My Cases. If we click on an Open a New Case button, it's going to bring us to the New Case page. From here, we can enter a title, and once again, this is going to use case deflection to try and deflect a case from being created. Once a customer has filled out all of the relevant information, they can also attach a file and click the Submit button. Once they've done this, it's going to appear in Dynamics as it would any other case. This also allows customers to see any activities that have been left on a case using portal comments. If we go into an existing case and scroll to the bottom, we can see that it's got a timeline as it would in Dynamics. A customer can go ahead and add a comment, and we can add a new portal comment from within Dynamics 365, and all will appear here. Finally, a customer can go ahead and close a case. This is going to close it in Dynamics 365, so we know that we don't need to action this case anymore. I hope you've enjoyed this quick video about Dynamics 365 Customer Self-Service Portals. If you've enjoyed it, please leave a like and subscribe to Preact to see more of our videos about Dynamics 365 and the Power Platform in the future.